my primary question is that you misconstrue a lot of data on your show and tell a lot of outright lies. And you did a lot so here, but you know, you talk a lot about rationality and a good discussion, a lot of, you know, reasonable stuff. But it was curious, when you were talking, I didn't hear any science. I didn't hear any rational discussion. And if you want to have rational discussion, say about, I don't know, climate change or transgenderism, I actually have studies here. I mean, that would take too much time, but I don't know how much you'd be interested
in that. Give an example of a lie that I said.
The 6,000 kids, you said that were given hormone blockers because of some trans conspiracy?
I corrected that the next day when the news was corrected.
Yeah, well, corrected, but it was in the study. You said it was a trans activist or some trans conspiracy.
No, I said it was a drug that was used for transgender kids, yeah, which is true. And I said that it had caused 6,000 deaths, which is true. But what I misspoke and what was misreported in the news is that all 6,000 were kids. And that obviously was not true. And I corrected it on my show the next day.
You can't dispel the rationality here. It's your responsibility.
Well, I think it's very rational to correct yourself when you make a mistake. And that's why I do it every time I can.
But I think it's your responsibility as a political commentator to a lot of impressionable young people here that you report accurately. And that's not
I agree. And that's why when I do make a mistake, rare though it may be, I correct myself. Is there an example? You said I told a lot of lies tonight. What would be an example of that?
Lies tonight? Well, no, you didn't say lies tonight. You lack rationality. You didn't cite any evidence to talk about the climate change.
I said that the mankind is not going to be wiped out within 20 years because no scientist says... I'm sorry?
Science would disagree.
Which scientist?
The 97% of all scientists who say that 1 to 2 degrees Celsius will melt the ice caps such that there will be rising sea levels, mass extinctions, and it won't end the Earth. But it will change to a certain point the ecology of our planet such that it is much more difficult for humans to survive. That is the consensus. And a lot of climate change deniers like yourself, like Ben, like Clavin, they perpetuate that this is all a liberal hoax and that science...
No, I'm not saying it's a liberal. I mean, it's obviously being pushed by politicians primarily. That's why at the United Nations, it's not...
politics. Politicians are going to push political issues.
Right, it's politics, not science. That's my point.
No, you take the science and then you say... I don't disagree.
Which study?
You're
because what you're citing, that 97% number has been around for a long time. Al Gore used it in his movie. One issue with that is, first of all, science is not made by consensus. But second of all, the questions that were asked were such broad questions as to a whole array of scientists, many of whom had no expertise in the climate whatsoever. So to use a consensus number, especially one that's so old and has been so manipulated by politicians, is, I think, not really getting to the point. We don't take polls to figure out scientific data. So if you think the world is going to end in 20 years, I thought you said that you thought so.
It's going to change to a certain point such that human habitation will be more difficult and it will be vastly different. I'm not a doomsday, you know, idiot. And it's not an old figure. It's ongoing. It's right now.
No, it's a figure is decades old.
It's right now.
The 97% figure is decades old.